it's important, brothers and sisters, that we understand the history of May Day. May Day has its origins on May 1st, 1886, a year after workers in the state of Illinois got a law passed for the 8-hour workday. See, we take the 8-hour workday for granted, but there was a time in this country when you had to work from can't see in the morning till can't see at night. You went home when the boss told you to go home. But workers began to organize across this country for an 8-hour workday. The demand was 8 hours of work for 10 hours of pay. Did you know that that was the slogan in the 19th century? It wasn't 8 for 8. It was 8 hours of work for 10 hours of pay. They were smarter in the 19th century than we are in the 21st century. They said 8 hours for work, 8 hours for rest, and 8 hours for recreation. This is the origin of the 8-hour workday. And there was a massive general strike called across the United States. And there was a demonstration in Haymarket Square in Chicago. And there was an altercation. Someone threw a bomb. They never brought to justice the person that actually threw the bomb. They accused 8 workers who had nothing to do with the throwing of the bomb, and they put them in a kangaroo court and gave them death sentences. And one of those workers was a man named Albert Parsons. He was the husband of Lucy Parsons, a black female radical in the 19th century, had campaigned against slavery, campaigned for workers' rights, and campaigned for women's right to vote. Her name was Lucy Parsons, and her husband was Albert Parsons. And in honor of May Day, whose origins are right here in the United States, I know you think May Day is a communist holiday, but it started here in the United States. It was a demand of working people for the 8-hour workday. And after Albert Parsons had been convicted and sentenced to death, he wrote this letter to his wife, Lucy Parsons, on Chicago on August 20th, 1886, from his jail cell in the Cook County Jail in Chicago, Illinois. He says, "My darling wife, our verdict this morning cheers the hearts of tyrants throughout the world, and the result will be celebrated by King Capital in its drunken feast of flowing wine from Chicago to St. Petersburg. Nevertheless, our doom to death is the handwriting on the wall, foretelling the downfall of hate, malice, hypocrisy, judicial murder, oppression, and the domination of man over his fellow man. The oppressed of earth are writhing in their legal chains. The giant labor is awakening. The masses, aroused from their stupor, will snap their petty chains like reeds in the whirlwind. We are all creatures of circumstance. We are what we have been made to be. The truth is becoming clearer day by day. There was no evidence that any one of the 8 doomed men knew of or advised or abetted the Haymarket tragedy. But what does that matter? The privileged class demands a victim, and we are offered a sacrifice to appease the hungry yells of an infuriated mob of millionaires who will be contented with nothing less than our lives. Monopoly triumphs. Labor in chains ascends the scaffold for having dared to cry out for liberty and right. Well, my poor dear wife, I personally feel sorry for you and the helpless little babe of our loins. You I bequeath to the people, a woman of the people. I have one request to make of you. Commit no rash act to yourself when I am gone, but take up the great cause of socialism where I am compelled to lay it down. My children, well, their father had better die in the endeavor to secure their liberty and happiness than live contented in a society which condemns 9/10 of its children to a life of wage slavery and poverty. Bless them. I love them unspeakably, my poor helpless little ones. Our wife, living or dead, we are as one. For you, my affection is everlasting. For the people, humanity, I cry out again and again in the doomed victim cell. Liberty, justice, equality. Those are the words of Albert Parsons on May Day in 1886. So we stand here today, brothers and sisters, to once again demand justice for working people all across this world. Honk your horns for jobs. Honk those horns. Honk those horns for jobs and economic justice. That's right. Thank you, Transit. Thank you. Honk those horns. Honk those horns.